Thank you. I'm going to move around. Thank you. Small and obscure though I am, and utterly despised, you rose of life, I have not forgotten, alleluia. My pleading voice, hear, O my Lord, in your great mercy and in your justice, grant me life, alleluia. Rulers unjustly persecuted me, but my heart has always stood in awe of your words, alleluia. Let my soul live, and it shall praise you, and your commandments shall assist me, alleluia. I wander as sheep who lost the trodden path. Come and seek your servant, Lord, for your commandments I have not forgotten. Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, τον Αγίον ο χορός ευρεπηγήν τη ζωή και θύραν παραδείσου, ευρωκαγώ την οδόν δια της μετανοίας, το απολωλός πρόβατον εγώ ημί ανακάλεσέ με, σωτήρ και σώσον με.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, ο πάλεμε με κμιόντο πλάσας με και εικόνη σου θεία τιμήσας, παραβάσει εντολής δε πάλι με επιστρέψας, εις γυναίξης ελήφθην, εις το καθομοίο συνεπανάγαγε το αρχαίο κάλος, αμαμορφώσαστε.
Ευλογητών η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου, εικόνη μη εις αρήτου δόξη σου, ή και σφίγματα φεροντεσμάτων, υπήρησον το σόν πλάσμα δέσποτα και καθάρισον σιέψ πλαχνία και την ποθινή πατρίδα παράσκουνη παραδείσου πάλι ποιόν πολύμνε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα σου, ανάπαυσον ο Θεός των δούλων σου και κατάταξον αυτόν παραδείσο, όπου μπορεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εν κλάψος είναι ως τύρες, τον και κοιμημένον δούλον σου ανάπαυσον παρορών αυτού πάντα τα μαρτήματα.
Όσο Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίο Πνεύματι, το τρίλαμπες της μιας θεότητος, δεύσε βόση κλείσομεν πόντες, Άγιωσι ο Πατήρο άναρχος, ο συνάναρχωσιος και το Θείον Πνεύμα, φωτίσον ημάς
ελεύθερα, πάντα ονείρων απατηλότερα, μία ροπή και ταύτα πάντα θάνατο διαδέχεται. Αλλεντο φωτί Χριστέ του προσώπου σου και το γλυκασμό της ισορρεότητος, ον εξελέξω ανάπαυσον ως φιλάνθρωπο.
Like a flower it withers, and like a dream it vanishes and dissolves away every human being. Yet at the call of the trumpet, all the dead, as if an earthquake shall rise to meet your Christ, our God. At that time, Lord, rest the spirit of the one you have taken from us in the dwelling of the saint, O Christ, our God.
Πάντα ματαίω της τα ανθρώπινα, όσα ούχι πάρει με τα θάνατα, που παραμένει ο Λόγος, που συνοδεύει δόξα. Επελθόν γαρ ο θάνατος, ταύτα πάντα εξυφανίστε, δύο Χριστό το αθανάτο, Βασίλη βοήσομεν, τον μεταστάντα έξιμον, ανάπαξον, εν θα πάντων εστίν, εφρενωμένον η κατοικία.
Indeed, how awesome of our death is the mystery. How the soul is forcibly separated from its harmonious union with the body, and of their coexistence, this natural bond by divine will is broken. Therefore, we implore you, give rest to the departed one in the dwelling of the righteous, O giver of life and lover of mankind.
Πάλι κατενόησα εν της μνήμαση και είδον τα όστα τα γεγυμνωμένα και είπον. Άρα της εστί βασιλεύσης στρατιώτης, η πλούσιος υπένης, η δίκαιος η αμαρτωλός, αλλά ανάπαυσον Κύριε, τα δικαίων των δούλων σου ως φιλάνθρωπος.
I draw to mind the prophet who cried, I am earth and dust. And again I looked in the graves and beheld the naked bones and said, to whom could these belong? King or soldier, rich or poor, righteous or sinner? But give rest to your servant, O Lord, among the just, as a gracious and a loving God.
Αρχήμικε υπόσταση στο πλαστουργό σου γέγονε πρόσταγμα, που λυθείς γαρέξα οράτοτε και ορατής μεζόν συμπήξε φύσεως, δίθεν μου το σώμα διέβλασα. Δε δοκαζεύει η ψυχή τη Θεία Σου και ζωή ο εμπνεύσει. Διό Χριστέ τον δούλον Σου εν χωραζόντων εσκηνές δικαίων ανάπαυσο. Κειμένην την κατοικόδα Θεού, πλαστήσαν ημίν ωραιότητα, άμορφον άδοξον μιλέχους αλήθως, ότου θαύματος τίτο περίπτωση. τούτο γεγον εμπιστήριον, πως παρεδόρθη με τη φθορά και συνεζεύθη με το θανάτο. Όντως Θεού προστάξει, ως γεγράπτε του παρέχοντος το μεταστάντη την ανάπαση.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You death for mankind, O Lord, became the cause of our salvation. For had you not in the tomb been laid, for us paradise would open not. Therefore, rest the departed in your eternal love for men. Chapter 5, verses 24 to 30, let us attend. The Lord said to those who came to him, I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my words and believes in him who sent me has eternal life. He will not be judged, but has already passed from death to life. I tell you the truth. The time is coming. The time has already come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear it will live. Even as the Father is himself is the source of life, in the same way he has made his Son to be the source of life, and he has given the Son the right to judge because he is the Son of man. Do not be surprised at this, for the time is coming when all the dead in the graves will hear his voice, and they will come forth, those who have done good deeds, to a resurrection of life, and those who have done evil deeds, to a resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the Father who sent me. And for the forgiveness of all his mistakes, both voluntary and involuntary. God, the Lord God, will place his soul where the righteous rest, and will grant to him the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of his sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God. Του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν, ο Θεός των πνευμάτων και πάσης σαρκός, ο των θάνατων καταπατήσας, των δε διάβολων καταργήσας και ζωήν το κόσμος δωρησάμενος. Αυτός, Κύριε, ανάπαυσον και συγχώρησον την ψυχή του κοιμηθέντος δούλου σου Ιωάννη Κώστα, εν τόπο φωτεινό, εν τόπο χλωερό, εν τόπο αναψύξεως, εν θα πέδρα, πάσα οδύνη λύπη και στεναγμός. Forgive every sin which he has committed in word or deed or thought, for you are a good God who loves mankind, for there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sins, your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your departed servant and our brother Johnny, O Christ our God, and to you we ascribe glory, together with you beginningless Father, and your all holy and good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Δόξα σοι Χριστέ ο Θεός, η ελπίσιμον, Κύριε δόξα σοι, ότι νεκρών και ζώντων την εξουσίαν έχωνος αθάνατος βασιλεύς και αναστάς εκ νεκρών, Χριστός ο αληθινός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείες της Παναχράν και Παναμόμου Αγίας αυτού Μητρός, των Αγίων ενδόξων και πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων, Πατέρων και Μητέρων ημών, των Αγίων ενδόξων Προπατώρων Αβραάμ, Ισάκ και Ιακώβ, του Αγίου και Δικαίου Φίλου αυτού, Λαζάρου, του Τετραημέρου, την ψυχήν του εξημών μεταστάντος δούλου αυτού και αδελφού ημών Ιωάννη Κώστα, εν σκηνές δικαίων τάξε, εν κόλπης Αβραάμ αναπαύσε, και με τα δικαίων συναριθμίσε, ημάς δε λεήσε και σώσε, ως αγαθός, φιλάνθρωπος και ελεήμων Θεός. May you memory be eternal, our ever blessed, and ever memorable brother, αιωνία σου η μνήμη αξιωμακάριστη, και αείμνηστε αδελφέ ημών. May you memory be eternal, our ever blessed, and ever memorable
Hello.
Father, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
Να είστε πάντα καλά. You must be well to remember your husband, your father, your friend, our brother. Johnny needs nothing from us anymore. He doesn't need food, he doesn't need medical care, he doesn't need transport, he doesn't need anything. He only needs one thing, for us to remember him and to say God must place him in a good place. Να είστε πάντα καλά, κυρία Ιωάννου, να θυμάσαι τον άντρα σου και εσύ τον πατέρα σας. Δανάη, θα έρθεις εσύ να μιλήσεις πρώτη. Who is going to be the first? Come.
My dad, my best childhood friend, my father, my guide, and my mentor. From all the comments and condolences and conversations I've seen, everyone knows who my dad was as a character and as a man. Yes, he was a giant of a person who had time for everyone. As a son, though, I'm more privileged than most in that I got to see more of him and who he really was as a person in all facets of his life. As an athlete with a full-time job, training just once or twice a week where he could, he placed second in the world in what he loved, just to one of the biggest legends and full-time shooter, Robbie Latham, competing under such pressure while still having to run around the range, picking up after his little idiot son all day during the competition. Through that, he taught us to focus on what you want, dedicate yourself and your thoughts to it if you really want it bad, and you can have it. As a man, he made mistakes and some really bad decisions, as all of us men do. But he never stole or burnt anyone, ever. Just that, in this day and age where everyone steps on anyone to get ahead, speaks more to me than anything. He was a straight man's man. But most importantly in my eyes, and I swear to you, I'm telling you this as a man, not as his son. I'm trying not to be biased when I look at everything. There are great fathers out there that do amazing things with their children, but my father will never be matched. My dad came from a very, very hard childhood. He promised, though, not to be the same to his children. He was absolutely selfless as a father. His time was for us. All his time was for us. Okay, and his guns. Of course, his guns. He was with us every second he could. He was patient. Very patient. He guided us and he mentored us as his little people. He would rather just sit and watch us doing something for hours than go for coffee with a friend or a beer or any other shit. Sorry for swearing, but I know he would too. I have never seen any other man or father be all, absolutely all, for his kids. Only for his kids. If he was able to, he would say, "Don't stress, guys, I've lived. I'm happy." As his son, though, my biggest regret and sadness above all is he never got to be here to hold, talk, laugh, and sit to explain things and teach things to a grandchild. I know for a fact that the whole world, his whole world, would not exist outside of that child for him, and he would do all he would do is dedicate himself and spend all his remaining time pouring love and knowledge into them. And play with his guns a bit on the side. We as his children have extremely big shoes to fill one day in the parenting department. If we can be anything like he was, our kids are will be very, very fortunate. My dad found great joy in just sitting and watching people, his kids and even his dogs, do things that he helped teach them. He could sit patiently for hours just watching, taking in with pride other people accomplishing things. With that said, he now is in the perfect place to look upon us with pride and what he managed to guide us to accomplish and to be. I've honestly tried my best. I've always been trying my best, and now I'll try even harder to make it, to allow him to watch over me with pride. That smile and that glow of happiness in his eyes. Oh, and I will have a few drinks too, just to piss him off. He missed out a lot in that department. We love you. Watch over us. We will make you proud.
Dad, Pops, I don't even know where to begin or even how to end. I could only hope that one day my children may be blessed with a father as incredible as you. The way he raised us and taught us so many important lessons in life. I am blessed. We are blessed. I love you and thank you for all you did for us growing up. You never ceased to be a father on a daily basis. You raised us the best, and I could only wish to raise my children the way that you raised us. I try very hard to emulate you in every situation that I walk into, walking into a room and leaving everyone smiling. Yes, you repeated the same jokes over and over again, but they still managed to put a smile on everyone's face. I will miss my morning messages from you and your very entertaining voice notes. I will miss your spirit and your energy and your positivity, and I promise to make you proud. I'm going to read a poem that is in everyone's book, and we all felt that it was the perfect poem for our father. In loving memory of Dad, he never looked for praises. He was never one to boast. He just went on quietly working hard for the ones that he loved the most. His dreams were seldom spoken. His wants were very few, just his guns and his dogs and his kids. And most of the time, his worries went unspoken too. He was there, a firm foundation through all our storms in life, a sturdy hand, large ones at that, to hold on to in times of stress and strife. A true friend we could turn to when times were good or bad. One of our greatest blessings, the man that we call Dad.
It was Johnny's wish to have a small funeral, to be simply remembered and wish not to leave a bunch of hurt in the hearts of those you so loved. Well, Pa, today your wish for a small funeral has to be honored, although not by choice. With regards to not wanting your loved ones to hurt at the loss of your presence, well, I'm sorry, Pa. That is not possible. You were too great to make that possible. Johnny left an impact on each and every one that he crossed paths with. Those who crossed paths with him were definitely impacted. From his own friends and family to, for example, the whole staff complement at the garage he always filled up at. He was greeted with shouts and whistles while pulling in, and I've seen no other like that. Each and every one of you shared a personal story of your time with Johnny, our father and our friend. Show us just how legendary he was. Thank you for sharing your beautiful stories with us. Johnny would have had way more people here today to say goodbye than he knows. That's for sure. It was torturous to see all of you unable to be here to say your own goodbye forever. For those of you who are joining in via the stream, I'm sorry you couldn't be here. To show your respects and to say your goodbyes. I know you would have wanted to be here. I know that Johnny was such a legend that this church would not have been able to accommodate even half of you that he has left a memorable mark on. To honor him and to pay tribute to a man that will never be forgotten. Not for his financial achievements, not for his superficial greatness, but for his genuine impact that he had on all of us. As his son, I cannot fill his shoes. Dad, I cannot fill your shoes, but I can be certain that I'll do all that I can to make you proud. And that's all you would have wanted from us. I watched Johnny create the change in those around him that made them want to live, you know, to feel alive again. To change that, the change that made them gravitate towards doing what brings them joy in their heart of hearts. That's what Johnny did to everyone around him. The change that made them feel like they had something to live for. Unfortunately for some of us out there, we will never get to spend time with you again and enjoy the days with you and all your toys. Johnny, for those whose lives he touched, is unforgettable. With that said, I know that you were always proud of me, Pa. I only wish that you could see everything I do that makes you proud. Because with patience, love and care, and damn it, man, you had unmatchable passion. If you think Johnny was able to teach a thing or two to you in just one sitting, that will be profoundly life-changing. Well, my sitting with him has been 32 years. Or as he would say, 32 years too short. I'm done speaking now, but I'll never be done with positive things to say about you, my father. I love you, and goodbye, Pa.
This is from Prisca. I knew Johnny and his family from 1992 when I started to work for them. But Johnny wasn't just my boss. He is my friend and a brother you cannot even explain. I am shattered. Prisca. Before I begin, I want to take a moment for a few thank yous. Thank you to everyone for the countless messages and phone calls throughout the last month. The amount of care, calls, and prayers was really, really overwhelming. To Costa Kotsalakos for being an incredible friend to my father and for arranging the treats we have outside that my dad would have so loved. While going through life with Dad, whenever he went to a funeral, we used to ask, why do you go to funerals? He'd always say, well, there's food. So the sticker is fitting for exactly what my father would have said today. To the Ioannou family, thank you for being with us daily and for your immense help. Mom, Prisca, thanks for being there. To Neil, I'm not sure I thank you enough for being my pillar of strength. I'd like to take a moment to truly thank my brother Nicholas. Nikki, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for your tireless caring of Dad at all hours of the morning for what felt like days on end. And to Dr. George from the Glenwood Hospital for being the only person who guided us through my dad's last days. we're filled with gratitude for what you did for us. To my dearest dad, it's so difficult for us to put in words the honor that my father was. It's never easy to capture my dad in a speech, as I know words will definitely fall far below the mark of capturing the greatness that he was. A man in a million, a charismatic personality, so large it filled every corner of every room, and yet a man so patient, so gentle, and so kind. Dad was hardworking, with a never-say-die attitude toward everything in his life. He was a brilliant man, logical, so capable, and extremely dedicated. He was so deserving of the success and the rich life that he so enjoyed. He always lived his life full throttle, a great lover of the outdoors, of laughing, the bush, a good hunt, camping, cars, scuba diving, microlighting, boat cruising, bike riding, a springbok, shooting range. The list is endless. Of the many things he loved, to top it off, he loved sweet stuff, Pepsi Max, lip ice and hand cream, the things I brought here today to take with him. But there was three principles that my dad lived by, and he would announce it to anybody that he met. I don't drink, I don't smoke, and I don't gamble. A better mentor and role model we could not have wished for. Of the many, many lessons my dad taught us, the most important, he gave us the ability to know that if you put your mind to something and really give it hell, as he would say, anything's possible. Dad, I pray to live in your honor, to appreciate every sunset and sunrise just as much as you would have. To look at something as simple as a blue open sky or a blue pool and take it all in and truly own every second that this world could give, because as you'd say, oh man, this is a lack of life. My dad lived for his family, and man, Dad, I wish we were here with the four of us together under one roof. You would have been beaming. Dad, I'll take care of Nikki, and I promise you I'll make sure you put your tools back where they belong. And that together, the four of us will appreciate the incredible legacy that you have left behind. Mom always said I was a dad's girl, and I'm at peace knowing that I had no qualms telling you countless times how much I love you, how much I idolized you, and how far beyond grateful I was to have you as my dad. I'm just not at peace knowing that there are so many days ahead of me that you will not be a part of. One thing that I know is for sure, that I'll miss you with every ounce of my being, even more than I already do now. I'll miss you on all my big days and all my small ones too. Today is just the beginning, and I know the hardest days are ahead of me. And I can hope and pray that the guiding force that you were for me during my life remain vivid in my mind for you to steer me through this time. As much as I'll be counting the days to see you again, Dad, I know for sure I have the best guardian angel up there right now. Until we meet again, Dad, rest easy.
We can go now to say to pay the last respect to Johnny. Sympathize the family, but please, please keep distances. Please, without hugging each other, we can show our love as well. Please, COVID is still here, and we need to be very careful. Thank you.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.